race, Speed flashes back to every scene that happened in the movie up to that point. So it makes the movie twice as long as it needs to be.
You're like, guys, this isn't like a TV show towards the end where we're remembering episodes that happened 9 hours ago. This just happened 20 minutes ago.
Right. We like, look, this movie's been on so long, you probably forgot all the stuff we did up to now. So here we go again. And with the flashbacks, okay, I know Matthew Fox is in this movie, but it's almost like they were shooting an episode of Lost, the way all the flashbacks happen out of sequence. Like, it's all about time being mixed up in different ways.
Yeah, see, this movie, every time somebody was told the simplest thing, they had a flashback. Like, if you ask me, Corey, you want some orange juice? I remember orange juice. I was 4 years old. My mom gave it to me fresh squeezed. And then they go through your whole life after that.
But you know what was awesome about that final race? It was narrated by goddamn Shaft. That was pretty awesome.
Yeah, Richard Roundtree coming in for the surprise appearance. You're first like, wait a minute, what the hell is he even doing here?
And then he narrates the whole race, and I thought that was pretty cool. Well,
him and the guy from Coupling are doing the narrating at the end.
The studly guy from Coupling.
If you call coming up on the screen, again, your head going across the screen while you go like, woo, that speed race is bad, boy! Then yes, he did narrate. I don't think he really narrated as much. He just exclaimed a lot of stuff.
Yeah, I'm wondering how that was even shot. I gotta say, as much as I expected to like the actors in this, I felt like a lot of them were in different movies. And really, it seemed like only Matthew Fox was the only one who actually saw a Speed Racer cartoon and was really trying to be Racer X, and everybody else was just kind of doing their own thing.
Which is funny, because I saw him and I just said, you know what, you don't care about this movie, Matthew Fox. You just want to be in an X-Men film. Because he might as well be wearing an X-Men outfit here. It's all leather with a big X on it.
You're like, yeah, but that's, you got to admit,
with a mask.
That's actually where a lot of that inspiration came from, was that character. That character was the first really badass mask guy in the 60s.
Racer X was the first really cool superhero or cartoon character,
because he's dark and troubled.
Yeah, and I remember Racer X from the cartoon. I think that Matthew Fox captured that very well. I liked him probably the most out of anybody in this movie.
Yeah,
I'm sitting up here complaining about the movie. I think the movie for a children's film has a lot of problems. But I don't think it's going to take away from kids having fun when they go see it. It's big. It's colorful. It has a lot of cool action in it. For the most part, it's inoffensive. So I would give it a matinee.
You know, the thing is, this is a movie that doesn't need a director's cut. It needs a producer's cut. You know,
ooh,
they need to take a lot out of this, because if you lose a half hour, it is the ultimate kids movie. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you want to keep your kid occupied out of your hair for 2 hours, this would be the movie to do it with. Unfortunately, your kids are going to run off for these 10-minute sequences that keep happening when absolutely nothing happens in it. Regardless of that, I enjoyed the effects and the racing. I thought it was fun. It kept getting me back into it. I'm going to give it a low matinee.
You know, I dug the hell out of this. It took me back to, you know, being a kid and mixing Pixie Sticks with Jolt Cola and just going, and that's what this movie was. It was, for 2 hours and 9 minutes. And I kind of dug the hell out of it. I really do think the beginning's slow, but the end really pays off. And by the end, I walked out and said, you know what? That was a really fun summer film. I'm going to say, as far as a summer film goes, this is a full price.
Wow. Well, I hate to be the odd man out. I mean, I know I wasn't expecting to be certainly a direct translation of Speed Racer, but I was hoping it would have that pace, or at nothing else, just don't bore me. And I was bored through a lot of it.
I was too.
It was just, all the things y'all said are good about the color and the action, it got to be sensory overload to the point of like, this means nothing to me anymore. And if I have any my biggest regret about the whole thing is like, it's what they do often with these characters, what they take from other things. In the original cartoons, all these characters were slightly obnoxious. All of them. And here, they just like smooth them out so everybody can be likable and everybody gets equal screen time. It just didn't do it for me. I'm going to go rental on this.
Wow. And it bored me too. I'm speaking from the level of a kid. I'm thinking kids.
Sure. No, I think kids will love it.
Yeah.
And I can't begrudge them that.
But I'm with you there. I really was bored. I was sitting there like, damn, come on, man. That British dude was talking before. He gave about a 5-minute piece of dialogue. And I was like, shit, man. I don't even think he had anything to say. I think he just went off on his own. They just let the camera roll.
Dude, but see, I was happy when he came on, because at least he was chewing up scenery.
He was funny, though.
But dude, you're out of your goddamn mind. That's a thing called exposition. You know, he was telling this story, and it's really cool because this whole movie is about corporate corruption, and it's a film entirely. It's a kid's film entirely about distrusting the man.
See, I didn't get that deep with it, but I tell you, exposition.
Well, yeah, you wouldn't.
No, the exposition is. Have you ever like known the rule of show, don't tell? And there's a point where you're like, damn, this dude is telling a lot of shit, and we don't need to even know that much because it don't make no goddamn sense anyway.
Well, they are kind of showing at the same time, though. All the exposition is done with a series of montages in this film,
and it's pretty cool. I actually dug what they did with this. I thought it was a lot of fun.
But you know, this isn't even really Speed Racer, though. I mean,
So
says the guy who watched it all the time.
I know enough about Speed Racer to tell you that this is far more futuristic than that show ever was. I mean, it's like they took Speed Racer and felt like they had to upgrade it to another. I mean,
that is the weird thing about this movie, especially in the first like 10, 15 minutes. You realize this is in a completely different reality altogether. In fact, I was trying to figure out what the year was.
Yeah.
Because they kept talking about the race of 43. Yeah. And it was like 20 years ago. So it's like, wait, it's 1963?
No, you're thinking 2143.
Yeah. Apparently. Speed Racer crossed with Wipeout XL.
Yeah, it's like somebody went to the Blade Runner universe and said, you know, we really need to clean this town up and make it bright and shiny again.
Yeah, that's funny. You say the Blade Runner universe, and I kept thinking it was the Willy Wonka universe.
Well, no,
it was like watching Willy Wonka, but every so often it went like, oh, hey, we're going to let you play this video game for a while.
You know what I was thinking when I was watching this? I'm like, you know what? This movie is what Willy Wonka shows in that crazy batshit tunnel.
I wonder how many people that chimp attacked on that set.
Dude, he attacked at least one person. It was publicized everywhere.
You know, chimp see all those colors, losing his fucking mind.
Chim is one insane motherfucker. Do not fuck with the chim.
Well, apparently not. He attacked one person on the set. Yeah, that's some grip somewhere losing fingers, and he's like, "Fuck that monkey."
Oh no, they take ears,
but
balls.
I will say, I truly believe that Speed Racer didn't even exist in that world that they created. I think Speed Racer is a drug addict who overdosed on some shit and is in a mental home somewhere with a steering wheel in his hand, something with slobber coming out of his mouth.
I was waiting at the end for when he's doing all that crazy shit in the car for Morpheus to show up and go, Neo, it's happening again.
it's just some tripping dude with a PlayStation, dude. I'm telling you, it's some guy sitting there on acid, some guy sitting there on a lot of acid playing his PlayStation going, yeah, I'm Speed Racer.
Oh. Yeah. They're called the Wachowski brothers.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Indeed they are.
Yeah. No, it's the hell with Speed Racer. What'd you say was missing all that? Like if I was talking to you and then I just ended everything with
Oh, not just that, but like, you know, you can't have a Speed Racer where every 5 minutes where something dramatic happens, there isn't somebody going,
Damn, do you need a towel?
Wait.
Here he comes, Speed Racer.
Gotta get you a towel.